I gotta be honest, now that Tyrese is in his tank, front row and center, always looking at me, always excited to see me, I built this tank to be a tower tank. I not only built a 70-gallon acrylic aquarium, but we cut out the top brace and built this 28-inch tall tower. And I want this in here. Of course, when I was moving tanks around, renovating, some fish had to be moved. I had to give a few fish to some friends to hold on to until I have a space for them. But I thought, why don't we do the guppies here finally? Filter set up, everything's ready to go. Filter cycled, this gravel is seeded as well with bacteria. But because it has a wood background, like that wooden background, I thought, well, I don't want to have it just like this. One of the things I'd like to do, I was like, wouldn't it be cool if we did the standing logs in here like we used to? And then added in like 50 guppies. So I'm going to set this tank up and then we're going to go to the fish store. We're going to buy some guppies and then we're going to come home and put them in the tank. You guys will remember some of these logs. I decided to go with multiple colors. This was in a tank before, this was in a tank. This used to be in the 2000. So there's a few different types. And I thought, well, when you have standing logs and trees, a lot of the times you don't have all the same tree and all the same logs in the same area. But, oh, before, this is the longest one that I have. And I'm thinking about putting it in to this so it kind of keeps going up with it. I was going to go all the way to the top, but I don't have a long enough one that is this thickness. But I can do something like that. I think this is going to be super cool. We'll see what it looks like once we get all these logs in it though. I kind of wanted an open space too. That actually looks really cool. That's the one thing if you get these standing logs. These are not real. They're from Aqua Decor Backgrounds, aquadecorbackgrounds.com. If you use Joey15 at checkout, you get 15% off your order. So as this tank fills, we'll run to the fish store, which is an hour away and an hour back, and this is only gonna take like 20 minutes to film, to fill, so we'll have to get a little creative with this. I don't think I'll get...
There's your elephant ear guppies.
Yeah, these aren't gonna be easily breed though, are they? Ooh, these are nice though.
Yeah.
Are they all males?
They're all males, yeah. For the most part. I think those are all males and the flame guppies are all males. We do have some females up there, but then you're kind of mixed.
Ooh. How many is in here, do you think?
35-ish.
35-ish?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll probably just get all of those.
All the elephant ears?
I want all of those for sure. But let's discuss the Duncans.
The Duncans?
Yeah. Yeah, because these would be super easy. Not necessarily super easy, but I'd be able to do it. So I think I'll take all these Duncans. Well, wait. No, there's like 50 heads here. It's going to be like $500, $600. Yeah, that'd be like, oh, this wouldn't be too bad. It's about $400 worth here. If I had to estimate like quick. I don't know if I'll take your GSP.
Do you want all of the Duncans?
Yeah, except for these ones. So I think you guys are going to be pretty proud of me. I was relatively responsible while I was there. It was really hard for me not to buy everything, but I think it's better that I get what I go for, and if I see something that was already in the plans, pick it up. But it's okay, because I want these tanks to be awesome. What I did get was, I think, about 60 elephant ear guppies. They're all males, incredibly colorful, and look absolutely gorgeous. Let's go float them, get them temperature acclimated. And by float them, I mean just put them over the tank, because I heat the aquarium gallery. I do not heat the aquariums. Let them get the temperature there. What else did we get? I gotta move quick because that tank's filling and we're gonna start it up, add those guppies here. But I also have some other stuff that I got. I also got, because I wanna do coral and different types of macroalgae in the saltwater tanks. So I got 50 heads of Duncan coral. These guys are incredibly hardy. They'll bounce back no matter what. They're not toxic either, so I'm not worried about touching them. All right, take them out. Got my glue ready. And We'll put a bunch of glue down so they're what they're attached to. You can glue to it. Not that it's necessarily needed because these are relatively heavy and flat-footed, so just a cute little 20-gallon Dunkin' tank. I think it's a nice idea. I think it's a really cool idea, actually. Marine glue will dry underwater as well, so I don't need to worry about it. It's relatively fast. I don't necessarily have to glue this to anything, to be honest, but just in case fish decide to knock it over. And this stuff grows fast. Grows like a weed. It feels like a hard coral on the outside, but then its soft tips will come out. Yeah. They're releasing a bit of a goo into my fingers. I'm gonna just fill it back up. And so long as this bucket is higher than the aquarium, the bottom of the aquarium, it'll just drain it in. So as you guys seen at the store, when these guys come out, it'll fill the tank a little bit more. I had to remove the bottom rock of the maple rock simply because it floated in the water. So when I drained the tank, it began to float up. I decided I'll just take it out. Plus, it's going to look better anyways because this guy's going to fill it. The downside, I have no clue what fish I want to put in here. All I do know is that I'm doing coral and or, well, one of them has macroalgae, so I'm doing coral and macroalgae. And I do know I want to do anemones. I might do anemones here, or maybe I'll just do a bunch of GSP and or GSP and mushrooms. Stuff that like you can grow with darn near any lighting and any parameters, because I think a lot of people are terrified of salt water. But I don't think you need to be. I use the cheapest salt, the cheapest lights. You guys have been seeing me do saltwater tanks off and on, of course, for over a decade. And I use freshwater fish keeper methods in salt water. Obviously, if you want to get into like heavy duty coral tanks, I'm probably not the one to watch. But I do have success with some of the easier coral and some of the easier fish to keep. And that's what this whole system's going to be. Just a lot of cool fish that I'd love to introduce you to. And especially you cichlid keepers out there, pay attention to the fish I'm getting, because all your cichlids in your aquariums came from the fish that I'm going to be showing you. This one here, should I do anemones in this one? Because it's much larger, it's 4 feet. Or should I do, maybe I should just do the anemones and I want to do anemones and clowns again. And then this one, maybe I'll do a mixture of different corals. Maybe I will do some, maybe I'll get more Dunkins or flame, some torches. A bunch of coral. I like the stuff that moves around and is actually alive. We'll see what happens. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. As for quarantining coral, they can carry in the same types of parasites and pathogens that all of your fish do as well. But it's far less common in saltwater than it is fresh. As for fresh, quarantine all the time. You guys remember the last time we had a parasite in the gallery? It was about 6 years ago. We had ick in here in just one tank that I was able to isolate, and it was the Walru tank, the Walru amphicanthoids. I was able to successfully treat it and rid it. Oh yeah. One thing I gotta do is suck the air out of this tower. And to do so, I gotta create negative pressure. So I just stuff this hose up into it. So, negative pressure created. That will stay filled with water now. I just gotta finish filling it. This tank is an isolated aquarium. There are no other fish tanks associated with it or going to be touching it. It has its own fish net. The only thing that I sometimes worry about is when I'm filling it, sometimes the pipe on the python's always touching the water. And you might be thinking of it like, a do-it-yourself solution to this. I just like the hose on it. I don't really use much else for it, but I've liked the hose because it doesn't clog and it doesn't really kink that much and it lasts forever. They're just so darn expensive. I wish the price would come down on it. With that said, when it comes to adding these guppies, should we quarantine them? This is their quarantine. This is only a 70-gallon tank. This is going to look incredible with all these guppies in it. You know what it needs? A little bit of plants, but I only have plants in one area that I could take from. Oh, I have a towel out here. The electric eel tank. Oh, and great, he's going over to where I want to take the plants from. He's hungry too, he's coming at me. He's looking for food.
So I'll just wait till he goes over there. I haven't even scraped the tank of algae lately. Go back over there, bro. He tastes my hand that was in the water. I'm not gonna go close to him. As long as I stay about a foot or two away from him, I'm not gonna get shocked. Now I'll try this side. Oh, great. I want these green little plants here, but I gotta be quick. He doesn't need them all. Damn it, stay away from me, man. He's very friendly. He eats whenever I want him to. Here, maybe I should... Maybe I'll clean this algae off real quick. I mean, it's not that big of a deal. I've been focusing on making sure he's happy. A lot of snails in here. I wonder if he'll eat the snails. I've been focusing on making sure he's happy and eating as opposed to, you know, obviously cleaning the glass. Okay, a couple more little plants. He's really close to me. He could shock me if I get too close. Oh man, my whole arm was in there. To be honest, I don't know how dangerous that is. I don't know if he will shock me. I know that it would be incredibly irresponsible of me to hand feed him, but I feel like I want to get shocked by him just to know what he's capable of. I do think that I'm young enough to take the shock, barely, but I kind of want to know, what's it feel like? How bad is it going to be? Will he only do it while I'm feeding him, or do I have to, I know I gotta touch him to definitely get shocked. I think that the test will have to be I'll hand feed him a piece of shrimp. He'll have to take it from my hand. Oh, let me know if you guys want that video. Yeah, so I think this is literally the only thing it was missing was a few like little cute little plants in it. Yeah, listen to the way I'm talking now that I have guppies. I'm like, oh, a little cutesy plant. Little cutesy wootsy. Little plants here and there. I think it just finishes it off a little bit. It did need something. What do you think, Tamara?
I like the plants.
Yeah. Of course you do, because they're cutesy wootsy. I like to plant these around the trees as well, like the branches or whatever. I just think that looks a little bit more natural. Plop and chop method. We're going to cut the bag open. We're going to make sure that this water doesn't get in with our water. Not because it's bad, but because we don't want to take the risk. This net is over a bucket, just like this. We're going to cut the bag over the net. Dump the fish into it. And we're left with just guppies. These guys are tiny. The only thing I'm worried about doing with these guys right now is acclimating them to the temperature of the gallery, which of course we already have. As for parameters, water hardness, KH, GH, pH, you name it, you're not going to be able to acclimate a fish's body to that within a few hours. Technically, it does take days. And while we never add the store water into our tanks, we do still risk. And I got to admit, the gallery has not had any pathogens, disease, or anything for 6 years. And I talk about the gallery because that's what most of you guys know about. But prior to that, it was many more years. But I still quarantine, and I still take precautions. Because it's that one time you don't, you wipe out an entire aquarium. You see it time and time again. It's a cute little tank. I'm gonna let these guys settle in. See, they're just acting normal. Swimming around. Tank's a little cloudy because when I filled this back up, the substrate was a little bit dirty. But that's just gonna help feed the filter for a little while. But, they're all looking great. It'll be interesting to see if they go up in the tower. Obviously, I'm going to have to put food in there to get them to go up, but... All right, let's give them a few days and we'll come back and do an update.
So it's actually been a few weeks later and the guppies are doing just fine. Absolutely very pretty, gorgeous. And if you've stuck around till this part of the video, it's time to like give you full disclosure. This is just a glorified quarantine system for these guppies. I didn't have the rack system built at the time that I got these guppies, but I do now. I didn't have any quarantine system set up at the time, so I put them in here. I knew I had to get the guppies or else I wouldn't have been able to get them at all. I wanted to get guppies for a very special tank. This one here. I think they would look absolutely gorgeous in this tank swimming around the moss log. The moss is just gorgeous. It just needs to be filled up with a lot of different colorful fish. And of course, guppies go with a lot of other things, so I'm sure we can add other things into it. Perhaps, you know what, we'll just do male guppies and, you know, I will get some females because this Java moss is just a perfect hiding area for a fry. But anyways, we'll do that in a future video and add them in. They need to quarantine for a little bit while longer now. But as soon as I add them in, I'll upload that video. Well, hopefully anyways. And if you want to see it, you're not subscribed to this channel yet, make sure you do. I'll see you then.